We've had a great AND conference. It's been an event that's brought people with different disciplines, different skills, activists, academic, business people, all enthused by the need to invigorate.
They're all about the interaction between people and not just going to a series of formal lectures. So I think that what an UN-conference is about is trying to say, can we enhance that aspect?
This is only my second UN-conference, and for me I just find them so incredibly useful because it's just such a variety of discussions and interesting information.
I think the discussion in the breaks have been very interesting, the panel presentations in the morning, and also the engagement.
I think PEI are great at convening, and I always meet a couple of interesting people.
The participants come from different places, not only different countries in Africa and Europe and other countries around the world, but also from private, public sector.
So it's really, really a good community here, and great to be here listening to all the thoughts from the participants.
You know, the different people are coming in, and each time you have like a layer of information, and then another team would come in and bring in another layer of information.
And I think that there is this need to kind of encourage collaboration in the data revolution, because everyone's looking at their own data sets, so it's quite exciting to see that.
Whether or not it's agriculture and agricultural development, climate change, the challenges of big data and how we use data, how we build confidence in data. All of those issues have science at their heart.
And we recognise there are some extraordinary scientific problems faced by Africa. We also recognise there's some fantastic opportunities that Africa has.
It was a really good combination of information gathering and knowledge updating, as well as talking with other people about new potential collaborations and exchange of information.
So being here today and hearing how researchers are looking at how they can apply big data to Africa's big challenges around agriculture, around water management, around enabling economic growth is really terrific.
It's really using science, how we use science to connect to humanity, how we're using this data to analyze and draw out meaningful conclusions from the data that will help influence policy.
It's also nice to see how Africa is working with outside parties such as the EU, and to see representatives from the EU being here to talk about the impact.
Talking about how you can build an Africa that is, you know, really taking advantage of science as a catalyst.
There's a lot of knowledge that is being generated, if you want, in terms of the perspectives beyond the data itself.
Not only accessing the data, how do you query it? How do you use innovative techniques to ask that data questions? But most important, how do you get people to use IT that's most relevant?
Because the data without capability to or to process it or understand for your own use, it doesn't have any value.
Well, I really enjoyed the competition, the data challenge. I think it's a very interesting way to mobilize people. I think, you know, what we had was a really interesting cross-section of sectors and also an interesting variety of levels of entry.
So our project was basically to get funding for a bioinformatics course entitled Bioinformatics Approaches to Genomics to run at Bingham University in Nigeria. We're so thankful to be one of two projects funded by Planet Earth Institute. It's really amazing. Our course is now 100% funded.
It's one thing I take away, it's that there's enormous goodwill, that there are an awful lot of people who want to be involved, who want to help.
So I think it's been a very engaging, very interesting, very innovative conference.
I'm leaving here with what people are sharing about the vision for 2020. It looks very positive.
So what we're talking about here today is an incredibly important area. It's 21st century science, but taking that and focusing it in Africa and saying, how can we actually really benefit the average African by doing that?
And the great news is that the world is waking up to that. And the PEI, under the leadership of our chairman, Dr. Alvaro Sobrino, is making a real difference.
Africa, best get ready, because there's a lot of stuff coming its way. Everybody's keen to really make a big difference, and I hope people in Africa are really ready to embrace that.